Hello again, so welcome to another video. This is the review of the Miria, and this is a clone actually of let's say Chewy Laptop SC. So it's a 13.3 inch laptop with some ports like USB 3.0, headphone jack, micro SD card, and on the other side we have the USB 3.0 DC plug, and this is the mini HDMI. So that's about it. What we get else more, it's this slot here. So this is the SSD slot that can be upgradable, and you will need the M.2 SSD. We can remove the cap here, and you can see I have placed inside a SATA drive from Western Digital, and it's a 2280 long SSD. So they will fit in here, and this will upgrade the performance a lot because the integrated eMMC it's very slow, and it's only 32 GB of storage, so not enough for let's say full-fledged Windows. And yeah, overall the build quality, it's not that great, I would say, but let me focus on the keyboard. The trackpad, it's very nice, it's very big, it has a okay click, not that good, but it's useful. The keyboard has a shallow depth to it, but it's okay. What else? It's very good for this laptop, it's the screen. So this is an IPS screen, and you can see the viewing angles are very good, much better than let's say the Lenovo S145 that I have reviewed earlier. And yeah, I like that a lot from this laptop, to be that cheap and have a very good sharp screen like this one. So yeah, I don't know how they manage that to be cheaper and have better screen, but I actually recommend only for the screen. So maybe this is useful like a portable reading machine, so you only use it to read some news or some PDFs or some documents, because the worst part of this, it's the CPU. So the Celeron N4000, it's let's say the latest Gemini Lake processor from Intel, but performance is not that great. I mean, I have run it with some CPU-Z benchmark, and let me show you the results. Okay, it's loading, and yeah, you can see here it's it's a 6 watt power device, and 40 nanometer part, and it has 4 megabytes of L2 cache. It's good enough. You can see here the BIOS memory. It's 4 gigabytes of RAM with DDR4, which is nice. You cannot upgrade it, unfortunately, it's soldered, and I will post here the picture, and you can see it's one die, so this is soldered to the motherboard, unfortunately. The graphics, they are very good. I mean, it's UHD graphics with some good performance, and the benchmark for the CPU, let's run it. So you can see it's roughly 400 points. So this is on par with an old Core i3 4000 series or a Core 2 Duo, a very good Core 2 Duo. But yeah, you're limited by the CPU most, because the GPU, it's actually reasonable. I have tested the Far Cry benchmark, and I will post it here. Okay, so the benchmark started, and we can see the FPS is very, very low. 1,
2 FPS, and this is expected because the integrated graphics it's tied down by the CPU. So if you go into task manager, you will see the CPU it's 100%. Of course the GPU it's also 100%, but it is rendering as much as it can. Also we have 3 FPS right now, still very choppy experience, and overall it's not usable at all. So this is running at 1080p and it's almost done. Yeah, and the average score it's 2 FPS.
So yeah, overall the performance is not the best, but this can be okay for web browsing. And let's try to open a heavy site like NASA.com, and you can see it's loading fairly slow. So maybe with Chrome the experience can be better, but you can see that the CPU stays at 100% no matter what. So yeah, maybe this is the, and the GPU also kicks in, but the CPU it's 100%. So it's a choppy experience for browsing the web. Okay, let's install the Chrome browser. Maybe this will be faster. And okay, so after installing Chrome, we can see the CPU is still 100%. Let's close this and wait a few seconds. Maybe the, but I'm guessing something it's happening, like Windows updates, because each time you want to do something with your computer, Windows update will be like, ah no. Yeah, you can see here Windows updates. They are really annoying, because they do not test it, and they just release the update and some machines just stop working. And yeah, okay, let's fire up Chrome one more time. Go to nasa.gov and see how it performs. Okay, it's a lot smoother with Chrome. You can see the CPU, it's still going up to 100%. But I mean, we see better performance out of it. Okay, so once I have restarted it, it seems that the performance it's a bit better, let's say.
So let's start to run the Geekbench mark. This is Geekbench 5, and it's the CPU test that it's running right now. And the overall speed of the video it's 5 times faster, just in order to see the results. And we can see the CPU it's spiking to 100%. So the test it's really stressing out the CPU, which is good to see how it performs overall. And we will see the results very soon. So in 3, 2, 1, let's see the results.
And right now it's done, and you can see the single and the multi score. Yeah, it should be expected to be this low.
Now we are starting to run Geekbench 5, and we will see this is happening faster at 5 times the normal speed, just to go faster over the tests. And we can see the CPU is spiking in the background, And also we see the GPU, so it seems that the GPU performs a lot of the, let's say, benchmark functions. So this is very good because it will offload the CPU and it will make the experience smoother, at least in GPU intensive tasks. So we're almost done, we have only 25% to go. Let's see how the overall score will look like. And yeah, you can see the CPU now, it's 100%, so CPU intensive tasks are running right now. GPU, it's also 100%. And let's see the results in 3, 2, 1. Okay.
Okay, so we have the score here. Okay, 1047. We'll see how it compares with other machines, but overall, yeah, it's okay. And what else we can do? So we can test on YouTube video in 4K to see how the GPU can render that. Wow, and it's almost working. I don't know if the network connection issue or something else. Okay, 4K video. Let's try and have a 4K video run. Okay, so we have the video running and it is in 1080p, 60 fps. Let's try to go to 4K. Okay, right now it's running a 4K video and you can see it's it can play back with no issues, and we can see here the CPU is 100% but the GPU it's not. So I think the limitation is the CPU maybe, but yeah, you can see it's very playable in 4K with no problems. So yeah, the GPU is quite capable on this machine, and the screen, it's also very, it looks very very nice. Okay, so yeah, for light browsing and seeing 4K videos, I can recommend it with no problem. What is more, let's say, likable about this form factor, because it's 13.3 inches. Okay-ish keyboard, not the best. Trackpad, it's okay also, and this is a fanless design, so it will be very very silent because of no moving fan and noise. So yeah, this is about it, and thank you for watching, and please like, share or subscribe.